Well, it's 2019 and it looks like true wireless earbuds are here to stay. After the success of Apple's AirPods, everyone is getting in on this market. So far this year, we've torn down Samsung's Galaxy Buds, which turned out to be some of the most repairable earbuds we've ever seen, and Apple's updated AirPods, which were almost identical to their first-gen counterparts. Today, we've got the Powerbeats Pro on our teardown table, the first wireless earbuds made by Apple-owned Beats by Dre. How do you get into the Powerbeats Pro? Well, it's slightly less destructive than the AirPods, but it's still a challenge. Using some heat, we soften the adhesive holding down the panel with the Beats logo. Then, using an X-Acto knife, we can create an incision along the seam, which allows us to carefully pry the panel up. There's not much to the inside of these earbuds, but what's in here is packed in tight. The tiny folded motherboard pops up and out, but the battery that it's attached to requires a bit more finesse. After carefully cutting through the adhesive holding it in place, we are able to pry it all up and out of the earbuds. There's a hiccup here though. The folded main board and the battery are still connected to a third small board, and that board is connected to the earbuds driver, which we can only access from the other side. Rather than whip out the ultrasonic cutters, we opt to cut the cable. This disassembly just got destructive. We've finally got everything out as best we can, and we can see all the pieces that make up a Powerbeats Pro earbud. First up is the coin cell battery, which is soldered to the folded motherboard via some incredibly delicate wires. This is actually the same battery we found in Samsung's Galaxy Buds. It's a 200 mAh coin cell battery that has almost twice the capacity of the battery found in Apple's AirPods. Seeing the battery soldered to the board is disappointing, but at least a replacement is not entirely impossible, theoretically. Next, we have the folded motherboard, which is home to the Apple-made H1 chip that is also found in the second-gen AirPods, supporting Hey Siri functionality and Bluetooth 5.0. Finally, we have the driver that delivers the sound. This driver looks pretty similar to the AirPods drivers, though they sound significantly better since these earbuds have better passive noise isolation. With the earbuds in pieces, we turn our attention to the charging case. Incredibly strong adhesive holds the case together, and unfortunately, our opening procedure ended up being less than precise, to say the least. Eventually, tons of heat and difficult prying got the job done. The upper half came free, and we got our first glimpse at the inner workings of the case. It sure feels like they don't want us getting inside this thing. Even the cable connectors are glued in place. These Beats do have an IPX4 ingress resistance rating, which could explain some of the adhesive we see here, but it feels excessive and a little sloppy. Finally, we make it to the battery powering this charging case, which, no surprise here, is glued in place. This battery is a 1.3 watt-hour cell, which falls right between the AirPods case battery at 1.52 watt-hours and the smaller Galaxy Buds case battery, which was a smaller 1.03 watt-hour cell. At the end of the day, these Powerbeats Pro fell far short of our repairable AirPods hopes and dreams. On the one hand, you can get into them without doing too much cosmetic damage, but actually making a repair and putting them back together is a whole other story. With that said, the Powerbeats Pro earned a 1 out of 10 on our repairability scale, and here's why. On the upside, the battery is a fairly common button cell and is only lightly soldered in place, meaning battery swaps are technically possible with the right tools. The earbuds opening procedure is not totally destructive per se, but it will likely lead to at least some cosmetic damage. On the downside, the earbuds' internal circuitry is all connected with fragile ribbon cables that do not detach, so a full disassembly can only be accomplished destructively. And finally, the charging case is a nightmarish bucket of glue, making potential battery replacements unnecessarily difficult and destructive.